the half-life of a chemical reaction is the time required for the reactant concentration to decrease to half of its original value. Graphically, we can look at it like this. It's basically an exponential decrease of reactant concentration. If we have a reactant concentration of 1, the half-life is going to be the time that's required for the reaction to reach half of that, so about right here. And then we can come down and mark this as the half-life. Half-life is typically abbreviated with a lambda, that is a Greek symbol that stands for half-life. So after one half-life, half the original reactant concentration remains. After another half-life, one-fourth of the original reactant concentration remains. After a third half-life, one-eighth of the reactant concentration remains. The equation for the half-life of a first-order reaction can be derived from looking at the integrated first-order rate law. And the thing to remember is that the concentration of A at time t is always going to be one-half the concentration of A at time zero, or the initial concentration. And so from that, we get the natural log of one-half is equal to negative kt. So rearranging the formula, we get the natural log of one-half divided by negative k is equal to t. And we're going to call this t a special name. We're going to call it t-half for half-life. So when we solve the equation for t one-half, we're going to get this equation right here, 0.693 divided by k is equal to t one-half. And that equation means that with only knowledge of the rate constant, we can calculate the time required for one-half of the reactant concentration to be used up for any first-order reaction. So in this example, this is the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide. This is a first-order reaction, and we're given the rate constant is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. To solve for the half-life, all we have to do is take 0.693 and divide that by the rate constant k. We can also use this equation to determine the concentration after one or more half-lives have passed. It's possible to solve this one, where it says what concentration will remain after four half-lives have passed if the initial concentration is 0.30 molar. It's possible to solve this by just taking the 0.30 molar and dividing by 2. That'd be after one half-life. And getting an answer, it's going to be 0.15. And then dividing it by 2 again. So after two half-lives, it's going to be 0.15 divided by 2 again. So it's going to be 0.075 and so on. Another way to do it is to take 1/2 to the fourth power. And this is going to be 1/2 is the amount that the concentration will decrease by after each half-life has passed. And 4 is the number of half-lives. And so this is going to give us a value of 1/16, which means that if we just take our 0.30 molar and divide by 16, we're going to get a concentration of 0.019 molar after four half-lives have passed. And finally, we can answer the question, how many hours will it take for the reactant concentration to fall to 25%? Of its original value. To answer this question, we have to keep in mind that 50% would indicate one half-life, and 25% is what would be left after two half-lives. And so we need to calculate for two half-lives. We're going to take the 38,500 seconds from part A. We're going to multiply that times 2. That's 77,000 seconds. We're going to convert that to hours by using the conversion factor. 1 hour is equal to 3,600 seconds. And so we're going to divide that by 3,600. And that's going to be 21.4 hours. It is possible to derive half-lives for other orders of reactions. So, for example, the half-life of a second-order reaction, T-half, equals 1 over the rate constant times the initial concentration. So this is different than the first-order reaction because in the first-order reaction, there was no concentration term. And so it didn't matter what the initial concentration was. You could still find the half-life as long as you knew the rate constant. And in this case, we have that. For the zeroth order reaction, it's a similar thing. T half is going to be equal to concentration of A at time zero, so initial concentration over 2K. Neither of these are used all that much. By far, the most common half-life reaction is going to be the first-order half-life reaction. So these two, while theoretically possible, are not used very often.